Thank you for joining us here on the web. I'm Erin Phalo. Manchester police are investigating a hit-and-run accident that injured a little girl. The driver struck the 4-year-old on Beach Street just after 11 o'clock Wednesday morning, and according to a witness, the driver took off. She says the girl was conscious and crying, but bleeding and severely injured. Police described the suspect's vehicle as a low-riding, older model red sedan, possibly a Toyota or Honda, with 268 as the first three digits of the license plate.
Some rust on it. May have some front-end damage to the front bumper, grill area, possibly the hood.
Other witnesses told police the driver appeared to be a man with a passenger in the front seat. Manchester police want anyone with information to reach out to the traffic division. Anonymous tips can be left on the city's crime line at 624-4040. Seven people were arrested last night after police raided two homes in Swansea and a third in Keene. Police say they seized over a kilo of cocaine, 8 pounds of marijuana, multiple firearms, and more than $15,000 in cash. Six of the suspects are facing charges related to the sale of cocaine. The seventh is charged with possession of cocaine with intent to sell. Authorities say this is an ongoing investigation, and they urge anyone with information to contact them. A Manchester teacher is recovering after she says she was assaulted by one of her students. Now Manchester School District's zero tolerance policy on violence is being put to the test. The alleged violence unfolded at Parkside Middle School during a reading class. The teacher says when it was clear the eighth grade girl was not going to cooperate, she placed herself in front of the door and called for backup.
Once I'm stumble, bumble backwards, it's just about okay, to the ground.
We've just developed and had the board approve a new code of conduct, student code of conduct, which really speaks to the issue that this type of behavior, if determined to be accurate, will not be accepted.
The student was placed under arrest and charged with assault. The superintendent says he's obligated to hear from all sides on the issue before rendering a decision on expulsion. Well, starting tonight at 5 o'clock, a 78-year-old grandmother missing in Vermont and believed to have been abducted. We'll have a report from her hometown where family and friends are preparing for a candlelight vigil tonight. Plus, a widely accepted screening for women that researchers now say won't help much if you're older than 50. The new study results about mammograms. That does it for this webcast. Thanks for joining us and have a great afternoon.